at Brereton has put him down. A bad miss for Hawthorn because he's the one who can really get them going. Now watch this on replay. You see Yates, there he is, number coming off the wing there. He only had eyes for Brereton and goes over and bumps him again. But obviously he's done his ribs.
Very interesting that he had a second crack at him, Don.
Well, they're all fired up, Geelong, and it's an ideal start of swimming. This is in 1978. When Hawthorn were, on that occasion, Moncrief Gold, as Ablett did on that occasion.
Part of the season.
Well, not so much his ribs, his ankles that have been the problem, Ian. But they've got a couple of players out that are under a cloud, Hawthorn. Now, Anthony Condon was getting treatment earlier in the week. Greg Deer was getting treatment. Scott McGuinness, we know, with the ankle. Brereton ankle. And also Curran. Now, they were getting treatment through the week, so they're not fully fit. Now, Brereton's going down to the forward pocket.
So, Geelong all fired up.
Well, you play for keeps in these finals.
Sure thing. Curran's kick wide to half forward. Marking contest up there. It's a clean mark for Dunstall. And Dunstall will have Hawthorn's first crack at goal. Opportunity for the Hawks to square the ledger. Dunstall, the early minutes. Drop punt kick is true.
The sweeping hand pass over the top sends Pritchard away. Down towards full forward. Brereton the test here. He's taken the mark. What a courageous mark.
Collins centre wing.
Well, that was a fitness test for Dermot Brereton. He went back and he took it. A bit happening, as you can see.
This is going to be the order of the day. I thought it might have started earlier than now, but what a great mark you called it, Dennis.
Down in the first 15 seconds of the game, a chance to kick Hawthorn's second goal from 25 metres out. He's put it through.
Centre, and the mark is taken by Kennedy. He's looking to play on, forced to kick with the left foot, into the pocket, he's down as he kicks it, and the free kick downfield will be taken by Curran. This was the doubt. So Curran, difficult angle, well within scoring distance. Magnificent kick by Curran, Hawthorn's third. Darcy to the members' side, Dippy Domenico can't mark, recovers quickly, gets his kick away, the ball runs free at centre half forward. Condon gathers, the hand pass, Whitman, into Anderson, he goes for goal and puts it through. Front Burke can't mark, Dippy Domenico can't get the ball out. Finally finishes off with Blackton with time to kick the ball long towards full forward. The marking contest, Hockney can't take it. Curran, snapshot, hooks it across his body, another goal to Hawthorn.
He's got it now, in trouble, the traffic is heavy, Couch hits the deck. Picked up by Dippy Domenico, down towards full forward, knocked away by Darcy. We've got a whistle, and it will be a free kick, I think, Hawthorn's way.
Against Gary Hocking once again.
Wasn't the kick taken where the ball landed? He kicks the ball, then he's down. That must be a kick down to where the ball landed, surely.
Been a certain goal, whereas here it's a little bit doubtful.
Dippy Domenico from 55 metres out. Good looking kick. That's a goal. Platten kicks inside 50. Darcy the leaper, fisting away. It comes down to Hocking. Very tentative Hocking. Dunstall, sweeping hand pass. Goal coming up. One of two. Bucanara from 10 metres out.
Slinger holds that up. He's caught play on. Curran takes the ball. Kicks the Hawks back into attack. In the 10 metre square. Brereton. Clean mark at the goal square. Brereton from the edge of the square. Directly in front. No problems. Kicks the ball to the outer side this time. Oh, Bucanara flies high, can't mark.
He's been penalised.
Now opportunity for Morrissey. Curran swoops on the loose ball. Curran's kick across his body. Up towards full forward. The high flyers. No one can mark the ball. Stephen Hocking gets it out the back to Buse. Great tackle by Dunstall. Terrific stuff by the Hawthorn forwards. Brereton will kick a goal. No mistake. Dermot Brereton kicks his third. The Hawks go marching on. It's a massacre at the MCG.
Morrissey's got the ball. The defensive side of centre wing. Kicks it wide. Pritchard runs onto it. That could prove costly. Pritchard from half forward pulls it back. What a superb kick. Dunster.
Here because Darcy went to where the ball was. Dunstall did.
Dunstall sneaks it through for a goal.
So it's time on in the second quarter, and the Hawks go forward again through Condon. Nearly the mark there. Catch Malakalos. Morrison swoops on the ball. The hand pass over the top. Whitman. Can he break the tackle? A left foot snap by Whitman. Another goal to Hawthorn.
Well, we asked the question, I begged the question earlier. Why didn't Boz
tell him about it? No free kick. Gathered by Morrissey. Craigan popped one from Dippy at a minute ago. Oh, it'll be reported, I fancy.
It's reported. Well, it's been coming because Dippy at a minute ago has gone at one or two. He went at that time at Hocking and he got caught. The Hocking not too good.
Tough, spiteful at times. Game of football. Deal long towards half court from behind. Brereton. Strong mark. Too far out to score. Dunstall goes on the lead to the pocket. That's the direction the kick takes. Hawthorn player down off the ball. Missed down there in the pocket. Anderson scrambles towards goal. What a massive goal.
And that was a magnificent goal. But then, what about behind play? Jamie Morrissey, not too good. He's got his hands down on his knees.
And bridge that gap before three-quarter time. Up over the top, Morrissey. Brereton kicks across his body. Now a chance for Curran. Curran's kick. Oh, magnificent stuff. Flanagan, and he bustles his way out. But Ayres is there to tidy up for Hawthorn. Ayres kick high in towards the forward pocket, and Dunstall takes the mark as Darcy.
That will be 50, should be 50 metres.
Well, you've picked it, Don. That'll put the Geelong defender right on the goal line. Surely will kick his third, and he does so.
As soon as Geelong mount a challenge, it's always answered by Hawthorn.
Bairstow. Bairstow's kick across his body. Dippy Domenico too tall for runs, and he takes the mark. He plays on quickly. Kicks it in towards Dunstall. At the back, it's a punch away. Morrissey somehow finds some space, gets his foot to the ball, and goals. Half forward. Great interception by Curran. He can't break away. Malakalos' handball is smothered. Hughes flips it back, but it's Kennedy who swoops on the loose ball. Bucanari to an open goal. Is this another Hawthorn goal? Yes, certainly.
Forward for Cameron. He falls over. Madigan did well. Got it across to Condon. To Anderson. Anderson, 35 metres out and closing. Is he accurate? Yes, he is.
Well, that's Anderson's third goal.
Morrissey got the kick away, or was it Whitman? It was Whitman. Morrissey gets the hand pass to Pritchard, who goes in short. This is Bucanara, and Bucanara gets the quick reply.
Four goals, Gary Bucanara.
And runs away. No great tackle. Whitman ran him down. Curran's got it. Kicks to about 20 metres out. Dunstall, great use of the body. Dunstall has kicked three. Make that four.
Can they gather the ball? Malakalos, Brung, smothered. Kick off the ground by Dippy Domenico. The Hawks have the numbers on this member's wing. Bucanara, over the top, Anderson. Into an open goal goes Anderson. And it's there, Hawthorn by 17 points.
That's the situation.
He kicked eight goals, Dennis, in the last turn.
What a fantastic finish. The dying seconds. Geelong need a goal to tie. And there's going to be a ball up. Valuable time is just ticking away. Down to 15 seconds now as play restarts. Geelong must get it immediately. One down by Flanagan, taken by Buse, upended by Dippy Domenico. They lock it up again. It looks like it's all over. The dream of back-to-back pennants is all but there as far as the Hawks are concerned. There's the siren. Hawthorn have won it by 6 points. A heart stopper. Ladies and gentlemen, you've just seen a classic. Amazing scenes at the Melbourne Cricket Ground. Alan James has made history for the proud Hawthorn Football Club. The heads are bowed at Geelong, but what a magnificent performance by the Cats.